Welcome back to a video series that I have not done in a while, and that is the How to Win. And I haven't done it for a couple reasons. One is I feel like most people have won a game at this point. It doesn't really help too many people. But then I forget about all the people who, you know, took a break and then like came back. We're gonna go to the airplanes first. I like the airplane landing because usually you can find a couple kills early, which I like. But if you don't want to play aggressive in any way, don't worry, you don't have to. All right, we're gonna go over five things this video in season 7 on How to Win. I should say season 7 because there's a lot of stuff that's different nowadays compared to when people played maybe in season 4 or 5 or 3. Alrighty, we nailed the landing, which means we should have the gun without question first. We're actually going to use the zipline just ever so slightly here. And you can use these to your advantage if you need to. Just when you do a little bit, you go a little low sometimes, you know? I don't think there's any other chest here, right? Alright. Well, if anyone wants to land here for a plane, which sometimes they will, you can get a couple kills really quickly if you are the good lander, you know what I'm saying? If you land very efficiently and very effectively, you can land before others and get weapons, and they will not have anything, which is great for you. Like this guy coming over here. He actually had a weapon because he came from Tree of Life, but he's also really not smart because I can hear that thing coming from a mile away. So he's dead. But in this video, I want to cover five topics, five things I think that will be beneficial to you if you are either new to the game, struggle with season 7, or possibly just looking to improve overall and get more wins. In this, I'm not going to challenge every person out there. I want to mention that now because I could very easily play very aggressive and go for many kills. I think yesterday we dropped a nice little 19 kill solo win, which is pretty cool. But I don't want to like try to get you into the fight like that. I feel like that might be the wrong way to take it. So let me look really quick. I had to write these things out because I wanted to make sure I had like five solid strategies for you. So the first one I wanted to talk about was landing, because landing is a humongous impact. It'll have a huge impact, especially if you play aggressive, on what happens in your game. If you want to land tilted, if you want to land on airplanes, some games you want to land at the sword up there on the peak, if you want to land at Salty Springs, whatever it may be, landing aggressive is one of the quickest ways to die. But if you have a great landing and you're very good at it, then you know it's a quick way to also wrap up a lot of kills if you're going for aggressive play. And you know, you can do that. There is advantages to playing aggressive. If you're kind of getting back into the game, you're trying to feel out your controls and stuff, playing aggro is not bad. I actually don't want to hold that. Well, I could hold that. We'll see. So practicing landing or getting used to landing on a certain spot that you like is not a bad thing. Some people are like, oh, you should learn to land everywhere. I disagree. I land in places that I land very consistently. Dusty Divot, Salty Springs. I land Shifty, I land here at the Plains, I land Polar Peak a little bit, I land Viking right now, I land Mansion as well. I'm pretty good at landing all those spots because I land there quite often. Junk Junction as well because I land there in solo competitive a lot. Places like Tomato Temple, Lazy Links, Retail, I can land there, but people who land there all the time are probably going to beat me because they're used to it, they're better at it. What we're going to do is leave the chug jug there. There's a trick we can use. It's not something I was going to talk about in this video, but might as well show you a little bit of a trick that's more of a high tier play. You don't have to worry about it when you're, you know, newer to the game, but I can show it either way. Grab some SMG ammo up here. So landing is your first thing you should focus on. Try to get better at landing and land in the same spot or in a consistent area so you get used to it and you get better at it, right? If you land first, ooh, that is a great drop right there. You will most likely have the advantage to get a kill or a couple kills, which can net you some decent loot sometimes, you know? And in game modes like the Solo Cup or the competitive modes where you gain shield and you gain mats off of kill, it's a huge advantage, right? You get like an instant 300 mats for doing it. So after the landing, I'm going to skip forward a little bit in one of these and talk about the loadout because that was kind of what I was briefly touching on. Like, do I want to hold the Porter Rift? Do I want to hold the Chug Jug? Depends on who you are, right? If you want double heals, you can. But the typical loadout you're going to see in a game for most players is AR, shotgun. Most of the time it's going to be pump because pumps are a bit better when you have an SMG follow-up. If you don't have a pump, use a tac shotgun. You don't need the SMG as much, so you can skip the SMG. But usually it's pump, SMG. Your fourth slot is your wild card, and then your fifth slot is your heals. Heals are usually going to be mini shields. Those are the best heals in the game for time used. Your fourth slot could be mobility, which would be a grappler, a porter rift. You can use a chug jug if you want double heals. If you want long range, you can go sniper. If you want more aggressive knockdown strats, you can use a grenade launcher or a rocket launcher, RPG, whatever. There's a lot of slots there you can do. Deagle as well is very good. It's kind of like the best of both worlds with knockdown and also being able to apply pressure and damage at distance. There's a lot of different weapons you can throw in your fourth slot. Because I want to be mobile, though, we're already in zone right now. We're going to wait a second while we talk about this. I'll use this and I'll show you a trick where you can use the rift, and then as you're using it, spam E and pick up the chug jug anyway, so you don't leave anything behind. But you also gain the mobility of the rift, you know? Now, I should have mentioned this already, but I didn't, and that is mine materials. This was not something I wanted to talk about in the video, but I should just briefly touch on it. You need mats to build, and building is an essential part of the game. That's just, you know, it hasn't changed. If you've been gone for a bit, you're coming back, it hasn't changed. It is an important part of the game. It still is, since forever, all right? Now, with building, I will tell you that your keybinds have to be good. Keybinds are an important thing because not many people want to use F1 through F5 to build. I don't use any of my F keys. That's fucking so difficult for me to hit. So I don't like any of those. But I'm not going to tell you what keybinds to use because, you know, you can decide what you find comfortable. I will put my keybinds in the description if you'd like to look at what I use. But that's just a guide. I know you can use what I use. It's up to you. We're going to wait one more minute here. We are going for the win. We're not playing. While we're waiting, what we can do here, I'll show you, actually. We are wasting a little time because we could be mining more materials. I was going to say, like, since we're in zone right now, we don't have to go. We could get near the center of zone, but we're going to play it slow. The goal here is to try to guarantee my win, right? I'm not going for high kills. It's, you know, if you're a newer player to the game and you want to go for a win because you've never got a win before or you struggle getting solo wins, I would tell you that getting into fights is probably better because you, at some point, you're going to have to fight somebody, right? But you don't have to do it. You don't have to do it. In fact, we're going to have a struggle in a little bit. I'm paying attention to the kill feed right now because I want to know if the guy with the sword is still alive and still in the game. If he's not, then I'm okay. If he is, then I still have to kind of worry about a sword play. And outplaying that can be difficult. Depends on who has it and what you have in your inventory. My current setup is not too hot when it comes to spraying things down that have a lot of health. My shotgun's good. But I don't have a P90 to take out a lot of HP, and I don't have a really good AR, so. Go to my mats right here. Head back here now. The zone's coming in. We're just mining materials. That's all we don't want right now. We just want to get some mats, so if we get into a fight, we can build and challenge people. So far, we've talked about landing, though. Your loadout. Your keybinds. Those are the three things we've talked about so far, right? Those are all very important things and very helpful to kind of get a handle on, right? And while we're waiting, I should mention, I guess, the fourth thing, and that is positioning. Know who to challenge, know when to challenge them. I'm not going to shoot that guy up there. There's no reason to. I'm gonna mine out some brick right here. I'd like a better AR. Ooh, we have balloons. So we could take the balloons to counter the sword, but I haven't seen the sword in the kill feed yet, so I'm not too worried about it. We also have an airplane I left down here earlier, so if I want to have mobility without actually using my rift, I can do that. I don't need to use the rift. So in this circumstance, with the current zone layout, there's a lot of hills here. I don't think I want to use the rift. I think I'm going to take the chug jug, and I'm going to use the airplane instead. I think that might be the better option. Now, keep in mind, a chug jug does take 15 seconds to use, so you're probably not going to get it off in the middle of a fight. The people will not give you that much time to use it, you know? They're not that nice. But if you do get a kill and you have the time, it's beneficial. Otherwise, I'll probably just use mini shields. It's no big deal. So my airplane keybinds are also different than your default. You can see them on the left-hand side, but keybinds are an important part of the game. Now, people will probably shoot at you if you're in a plane, just like this. Alright, we're going to challenge this guy because he wants to fight, so we're going to fight him. Edit out really fast. Alright, he has high ground now, which sucks. Now we got high ground over him. Did 98. We're going to spray him down now. He got a, didn't have a chance there at that point. So he did get some damage on us. How many grappler? Okay, so what we're going to do now. Grappler is really strong. I'm going to use the chug jug for the bonus shield. And I'm going to go for the grappler now. So I didn't want to fight that guy, really, because, you know, there's, if I don't have to fight, I'm not going to. But it did help us out. By eliminating that opponent, we got a grappler, which is really beneficial for mobility. And we got a way better AR. We had a gray AR. Now we have a silent scar. So, I mean, it can be extremely beneficial to challenge people, right? Like, it's not a bad thing all the time. But if you want to win a lot of games, you don't necessarily have to fight a lot of people. Keep mining materials as we move in with the zone here. So we've gone over landing, keybinds, loadout, and we're talking about positioning now. I wanted to get to zone and kind of look for people up on the cliffs and try to knock them off by boosting at them. But that kind of got in the way. All right, so the sword is over there. You see that light up in the sky? That is the sword player. Or it's the sword on the ground, actually. I'm pretty sure it doesn't actually show up as a light when a player has it. We could go for the sword, but for the sake of this video, if you're a newer player, you probably won't have the sword. I'm not going to worry about it as much. I will, however, guard it. Just because if I can keep somebody from having it, that will be helpful for me. We don't have to shoot that guy. We're not going to. The sword is over there. We could go for it if we wanted it. That guy's mining materials in the middle of the lake, which means he probably has an idea on how to play the game. I think the sword is going to be outside zone, though, in a second. That guy's going for the drop. We're going to ignore it. Again, we're trying to play zone. We're trying to play smart. My instincts say, go for that guy. Get him. But realistically, you don't want to be doing that. Quad crasher there. You can grab some ammo if you need it. Let's keep on moving. We got new zone. It's on Tilted Towers. Absolutely one of my most hated areas because I have the worst of frame rate there. But we do have a grappler, which lets us kind of travel through Tilted Towers much easier. This guy, on the other hand, he's kind of in our way. We might want to get rid of him. If we rotate him behind him or in front of him, he will shoot us in the back. He's not a bad player. Doesn't seem like it anyway. He's mining materials like he should be. So he probably has a good idea on how to play the game. He's up in the roof right now. If he breaks out on this side, we can shoot him. If he breaks out on the other side, he's probably going to head glitch us and we don't want to like push him. But when it comes to rotations, you don't want to rotate and let somebody be at your back the whole time unless they can never get a shot off at you. So ideally, we want to be at his back as long as he doesn't like hold us on the zone. If we were really far away from like the storm circle, like let's say the safe zone was way up here, then we would want to be ahead of him. That way we can hold him against the storm line. But since we're so close and I have a grappler, it's pretty much negligible. It doesn't make a difference. And this kind of comes into the positioning. Like, how good are you at figuring this out and positioning yourself? I could get on top of his house. He has the lamp right here. He has this item. So he has a default skin on, but he's not a default. All right, he saw me now. We can push closer. We're going to do is go above him here, I think. Here's a rocket launcher. You have to be careful of the explode now. He's in the house. He's going to break that out. There we go. So I was really careful of there is I didn't want to let him shoot a rocket launcher at me. This is another decision when it comes down to what item do you want to hold on to. If you want to have an RPG when you go into Tilted, would you rather have a grappler? Kind of up to your choice there. You can make whatever you want. While we're waiting though, having some knowledge of the map, I know that there are these little mushrooms around here, or as Nick Merckx calls them, berries. I'm going to regain some health before I have to rotate in too much further. When you fight someone like that and you make noise, expect other people to want to come third party you. So be on the lookout, be like looking around, be wary, you know. I'm kind of out in the open because I feel like I can fight pretty much anybody. I'm not too scared about it, but normally you're going to have some people want to come in and take advantage of the fact that maybe you just took some damage and you're weak just after fighting, right? All right, so we have a drop coming in right here. We're going to build around it with wood. Since we have max wood, we might as well. The last thing I want to talk about in this video which is something that you probably already saw, is the new items in the game. Knowing what new items can do to you and knowing how to use them yourself is extremely helpful, right? If you're a very good pilot, so we might lose positioning here. I'll tell you in a second. If you're a really good pilot, you can abuse a plane and be very, very strong and like annoying as hell. If you're very good with the sword, you can kill a lot of people. If you're good at getting the sword, you can kill a lot of people. If you know that the sword emits that big blue beam, then you know about it and you can go toward it as well and go grab it if you want. I don't want it, so I don't care, but. All right, we have one trap. So by waiting here and letting the drop come to us, we might have lost positioning because the next zone showed and it's on top of this hill, which means I'm gonna have to push into the high ground if somebody's already up there. Might not have been a good play. Now, even though you might know all this stuff and you might be able to use it to your advantage, you still have to be a decent enough player to take fights with other players, you know? And that's something that a lot of people struggle with. You might be a really good player, but oh my goodness, we have some nerds in this game. Who pyramid peaks? Good news is we have the high ground. So we have one guy playing like it's a scrim. He's a nerd on top of the tower. That kind of player is a loser. So we won't worry about him. He watched somebody play a skirmish once. I'm not sure what's going on with my colors. Why are there multiple people pyramid peeking? What are you doing? Have you guys never played a pub game? This is not a tournament. This isn't even a scrim lobby. No one in this lobby has been remotely decent. And if the circle is this big with only six people left, it is not a scrim lobby. It's whatever. We're going to hide here. These people are making lives much harder than they need to be. There's no reason to be doing this. Kind of bugging me that my colors keep changing on my screen as well. Oh, we're up here. Might as well mine some mats. The good news is, even though we don't have like the most mats, we're not sitting on max mats because we didn't eliminate many people. We have an absolute ton of mobility in the game right now with the grappler with 9 uses. So we're sitting darn near. Ah, damn it. On that tree. Ooh, that guy got the zone over here. This isn't bad for us. This isn't bad for us, actually. Because we have close zone. So we can kind of hold people on the rotate if we want to. So we're going to leave our side open. Just so I can like peek this guy down here. Alright, took him off 70. So we don't want to peek people for too long. These guys are really sweating. So this is going to be a lot of positioning here. Going to be a lot of positioning and focusing and knowing how to properly maneuver myself. The good news is I do still have a very large high ground over most players in the game, even with the current zone on the next zone. So that guy's going to reshield. We have some people that are really, I can't believe, why is this such a sweaty lobby? We're not playing in any pop-up cup or anything here. My FPS sucks looking at tilted. Alright, block that there. This guy has to rotate in, is the thing. Gone. Move in. So we gate kept that guy. Let's switch to harder mats. Let's double up as well here. All right, that is not good for us. That is about as bad as it could be, actually. Well, this is going to be one interesting how to win video, because this is like way sweatier of a pub lobby than you're ever going to get into. I'm not too worried. We have low ground, but we have a grappler. We can hug this cliff and no one should be able to hit us and no one's on this side of us. They're all on that side. It's supposed to be just like a really bad scrim lobby or something. There should not be this many people in the game trying like this. It's all right. I might not talk here. I'll probably focus up to make sure we can get the win, because this is, like I said, a bit sweatier than you normally would ever face in a game. Down. Leaves me to 1v1 now. Good news, I still have high ground. Keep applying pressure. He dies to storm. So in that circumstance, I got high ground. No one can really take me on that one. And the grappler helped secure that, right? A lot of tryhards in that game. It was really weird. I don't know why they were all pyramid peeking and hiding on mountaintops, but none were that good, really. Either way, we win. So, the five things I talked about, brief recap. Landing, making sure your landing is solid. Knowing how to get there quickly so you get the weapons first. Keybinds. Change your keybinds early on to something that you know you have a fair command of, not F keys and shit. New items, and again, if you want to see my keybinds in the description, the new items in the game, understand which items are coming in and going out so you know you don't get caught off guard, what was buffed and what was nerfed. The planes are new, the swords are new. There's a lot of changes that happen pretty fairly often, I'll say. It's pretty fairly often. Fairly often. That's the balancing changes. So understanding the meta, and right now the meta still is AR, shotgun, SMG, utility item, whatever you want. Or we'll call it wild card, and then your heals in your fifth slot. And then loadout, which was I just went over, and positioning. So understanding how to position yourself, avoiding lines of sight, while also being able to pick off people. You saw how I built walls in front of me, edited my floor, made a hole, and I shot the guy below me before he ever got like the launch pad. He lost 100 HP. That's a good thing with positioning. I knew I had to block off the guy that was sniping at me, but I also still wanted to focus the guy that was outside Storm and make sure he couldn't push in. So positioning's a big deal as well. We won the game. I think we had like, what, 5 eliminations? Not many, only 5 or 6. I hope you enjoyed. I hope this helps out a little bit. I could go over much more in-depth and like more pro strategies and strategic moves, whatever, at a different point maybe. But most of the time these videos are try to cater toward the guys that are like kind of newer to the game or maybe less skilled. So I don't want to go into like super elaborate moves that they may never need to use because they still are trying to work on the basics and the more fundamental stuff that you're working on, right? Thank you for watching, though. I'll see you guys next time.